Shabbat Shalom, Erev Shabbat, Parshat Vayishlach. My name is Moshe Lanyaro, speaking and representing Kolel Ahavat Yisrael. May they continue their good work of spreading Torah and Chesed throughout the world. My friends, this Motzei Shabbat, we will change the Amidah. We've been in a summer mode, and we've been saying Barchenu on the ninth bracha. But now, we're in the winter mode, starting Motzei Shabbat, and we'll be saying Barech Aleinu according to Minhag Sfaradim, and according to Minhag Ashkenazim, they'll start adding the Tein Talu Matat. In Israel, they started on Zayin Cheshvan. And the reason that there's a difference is based on the weather patterns in Eretz Yisrael, where water is needed immediately after Sukkot, and the weather patterns in Bavel, which water was needed much later. My problem is with Eretz Yisrael. If rain is needed right after Sukkot, and therefore we have said, Mashiva Ruach or Morit HaGeshem, on Shmini Atzeret, because that is the rainy season, why should we not ask for rain immediately after Yom Tov? Why do they wait till Zayin Cheshvan? And the Gemara answers the question, and it says because in the time of the Beit HaMikdash, there were pilgrims who would go up to Yerushalayim to bring the Korban to celebrate the holiday of Sukkot in the Beit HaMikdash in Yerushalayim. Therefore, if we start praying for rain, it's a little disrespectful for them because they came all the way from as far as Baghdad to be in the Beit HaMikdash, and we're going to pray that it should rain on their parade? Not so nice. Therefore, the Chachamim gave them a few days till Zayin v'Cheshvan to get back home and settle down. Then we start asking for rain. Okay, understood. But that's in the time of the Beit HaMikdash. Today, when there's no Beit HaMikdash, why don't we revert back to the ideal time, immediately after Sukkot in Eretz Yisrael? And the answer is that even after the Beit HaMikdash was destroyed, the Jewish people always, in their hearts, wanted to be in Eretz Yisrael for the holidays. And many people in the time of the Gaonim would go and do what? And make a pilgrimage to Yerushalayim for Sukkot. And even to this very day, many people take a vacation on Sukkot to be able to go and pray at the Kotel on Sukkot. And there is the Birkat Kohanim, which is something amazing that everybody should try to experience when thousands upon thousands of Kohanim bless the crowds at the Kotel. You see a mass of Kohanim giving the bracha of the Kohanim to all Klal Yisrael. My friends, in this week's parasha, we also see how much we love Torah and Mitzvot, how much we love Eretz Yisrael. When Yaakov Avino, our father, met Esav, he used the term, Im Lavan Garti, I have lived with Lavan. And Rashi says, what's Garti? It has the gematria of Taryag, the Taryag Mitzvot Shamarti. But that's not true, my friends. Why? Because he did not keep all 613 mitzvot. First, we know that the Avot kept the 613 mitzvot maybe in Eretz Yisrael. But first of all, he married two sisters. That's already against the Taryag mitzvot. And of course, all the mitzvot which are applicable in Eretz Yisrael, he didn't keep. So that is also proof that he didn't keep Taryag mitzvot. But maybe we could answer with another pasuk explaining to us what the word shamor means. Later on, when Yosef tells his brothers the dream, and they make chozek, they make fun of it, they ignore it. Yaakov didn't ignore it. It says, Yaakov shamar et hadavar. What does the word shamar mean over there? It means, and Yaakov anticipated. When would these dreams come true? Here also, my friends, Tayag mitzvot shamarti doesn't necessarily mean he kept all 613 mitzvot. He anticipated when would be the day that he would be able to keep the mitzvot. And that is a very high level. And that's what he was telling Esav. Esav, it's true I was in Chutz Laaretz, but the whole time I was in Chutz Laaretz, I was waiting and anticipating the coming back to Eretz Yisrael. My friends, we should also, even though we live in America, even though we live in the diaspora, let us be Shomer HaDavar. What thing that we anticipate with great longing to live in Eretz Yisrael, to live and do all the mitzvot in the way they're meant to be. My friend, it's a great thing to anticipate. And it gives us a energy to Bezrat Hashem start the move towards Geulah Shlema. Shabbat Shalom.